Hello everyone, peace of Christ to all. This is my video number two, exposing the lies of this man. He claimed to be a scholar. His name is Mustafa Yazid or Zaid, Yazid I think, and he have a book. In the video before this one, we showed you how he is claiming that I am inserting a sentence in the Quran and I prove it to you. And today we will mention or we will show another lie he made. Actually, it's less than a 30-second a conversation between me and him. It was enough to destroy his career if he have anything left. So just to refresh your memory, I'm going to play a part of this conversation, and we will go to the second lie and the third lie, maybe if we have time, he made in less than 30 seconds in my conversation with him.
Cry not for peace as long you have the uppermost. So this man is a liar and he has no shame. And we continue. In different verses in the Quran, you know, he just mentioned to us.
I would like to give him an opportunity to respond in 1 minute here after you make your third comment. So
first of all, I want the viewers to go immediately to the verse that the gentleman, and I'm being polite saying that he's a gentleman, where he claimed that وَلَا تَدْعُوا لِلسِّلْمِ. The verse says, and I quote, وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُوا بِالْأَعْلَوْنَ. Do not feel humiliated, do not feel sad, and God himself puts you in a higher status. There's no such a thing. Do not invite to peace. That's an insertion, a blatant lie, and he said it to my face. That's number one.
All right. And just to refresh your memory, we are going to go and show you a little bit of this as a proof, and we continue with the second lie. This is Quran Explorer, as you see in the screen. Not my website, a Muslim website, and we will hear, not only we will read together, here we go, you see it in front of your eyes. No, we are going even to hear the recitation made by Muslims in their website. And as you see, it says clearly that do not falter, and cry out for peace when you will be the uppermost. He said all of this is not exist in the Quran. I am inserting and I'm making up a lie. Again, I'm just repeating this because I want to put the two things together, and then we'll go to the second lie he made. But for now, let us hear the recitation before we go to the move to the second lie he made in his 30-second debate with me.
So do not falter and cry out for peace when ye will be the uppermost, and Allah is with you, and he will not grudge the reward of your actions.
You see it? He said, I am inserting. Now we will go to the second lie he made in this video. Let us continue and laugh together. You are history, Mr. Mustafa. You've been destroyed. Let us hear the second lie.
The second thing, God orders who believes in him. If you believe in me as a Muslim, enter peace entirely. If you do not believe in God, like you do not believe in God, why would you even listen to him? Why would even God be talking to you if you're not in the equation? And when it comes to dealing with non-Muslims,
thank you very much. So if this is, he's speaking about different verse. Let me show you the verse and the screen so you can see what we are talking about. And this is the second lie we'll expose for today. He's quoting chapter 2 verse number 208, and he's saying that this word in here mean peace. The fact I went with him in the word and I said the word peace too, because I wanted him to be more involved in his lie, to encourage him. So he repeated and he explained it, and he said yes, Allah is ordering the believers to enter into peace. The fact the word in here is not even peace. This is not, because his Arabic is weak, he do not understand the word. This is not the word peace in Arabic. This is the word mean enter into Islam. If we go on, just to prove my point, if we go and look at Muslim translation, not my translation, we will see the following. This is Yusuf Ali, as you see in the screen. O ye who believe, enter into Islam. This is not about peace. What happened here, that a group of people who Muhammad, you know, Muslims, they have many reasons to convert to Islam. Some they've been forced to, some they've been seduced, like Abu Sufyan. He gave him 100 camel to him and each one of his kids after they, you know, kidnap have many slaves, and Muhammad became so wealthy and so rich. So he started giving money, as the Quran says that, you know, you buy the heart of those who do not believe. You spend money over them, so they believe, no problem. If you cannot kill them, if you cannot fight them. So there is, let us say, three kinds of Muslims. There's ones who convert to Islam willing, like Abu Bakr, he converted from his own. There's people who have been forced to Islam, like the Jews and many others. And there's people who they convert from their own too, but by giving them money. So now Muhammad, in this verse, he noticed that those who he was able to convert them by whatever reason we mentioned, still they are not practicing Islam. So he is making a threat. And he is saying, oh, you believe, enter into peace, which means enter into Islam, otherwise you will be killed. Because he noticed that those people, they converted to Islam, but they're still practicing the old religion which they belong to, which means they are false converter, and they are not a true converter. They don't believe in Islam, because why somebody, he is a Jew as an example, he converted to Islam, still he practiced what the Jew practice. And you know what, to prove that I am not making things up, we will go to the interpretation and see what the interpretation says. If this interpretation agree with me, it's mean I am telling the truth and have, the word have nothing to do with peace. This is about entering into Islam, not about entering peace. It's about you converted to Islam, you practice Islam. Have nothing to do with war, have nothing to do with peace, except actually Muhammad making a threat that if you don't practice Islam and you forget about the old religion, I'm going to do something against you. You know, which means this verse is a very bad verse, not a good verse. Now let me show you with the proofs from their own Islamic websites and books. This is the official government website of the Kingdom of Jordan, chapter 2, verse 208. Here we go. Tafsir al-Jalalain. We click in here. Here we go. It's exactly as I said. The following verse was revealed regarding Abdullah ibn Salam and his companions, who, after converting to Islam, still observed the Sabbath. Uh-oh. What does this have to do with peace and war? And what are you talking about? So what Muhammad saying to him, enter into submission, it's not submission, this is wrong translation, into surrender, surrender yourself to Islam, you convert to Islam now, you practice Islam, otherwise, like, practice or else. This is what the verse in here is saying, it's an ugly verse, practice or earth. So if you don't do that, then I'm going to deal with you. It's a threat. So in here, the word in here, this guy, because he did not know speak good Arabic maybe, or maybe because he's just ignorant, I'm not going to call him a liar no more. Poor guy, you know. That verse alone to prove that he is nothing. The first one. Now, the second one proved that he is a potato. Not only he knew nothing, because if you are a scholar, there's no way a scholar in Islam, he did not read this. That this has nothing to do with peace. Secondly, the verse in here is speaking about those who believe, you know. Not those who do not believe. And he said, yes. Why Allah want to speak to those who do not believe anyway? I agree with him. Why Allah want to speak to those who don't believe? But in the same time, the word you said, invitation into peace to those who believe, as he claimed. So what we have to do with this? Nothing. Same time, the word in here isn't about selm. It is selm. You know, you do not know even how to read the word. It's a very clear threat from Muhammad that either you convert and you follow, and you practice Islam as we gave you, stop following other religion, stop being a Jew, stop being whatever, you are a Muslim now, so you surrender to Muhammad and you follow his practice. You don't pray to different prayer, you don't read different book, you do not practice different practice, you observe only Islam and Islamic teaching. And this is what the whole chapter is about. This is the book of Asbab al-Nuzul, and here we go. They are translating again, come all of you into submission. This is not about peace, you idiot. You are a joker. You have nothing to do with Islam. And you got, you know, this is what you need to do when you debate Muslims. You give them a trap. You know, you trap them. You make them think that you do not, agree with them a little bit. You know, just to draw them to the trap. Because those Muslims are a bunch of liars. And if you don't trap them, they will never give you the answer. You have to trap them. You know, maybe somebody will say, but this is not dishonest. You know what? When you deal with evil, I'm being honest myself. I'm tribing him, and I'm saying that publicly. I am tribing them. So if it's going to take me to play the game with you, I will play it to make you say the correct answer and expose you. So you want to play the game? I will play it with you. But I'm not going to be a liar like you, and still I'm going to say things as it is. And here we go. It says it clearly, oh, who you believe, all of you come into submission, into him, into Islam, and practice Islam. So You know, what this have to do, with the war and peace? You are a liar and you are a hypocrite. Let us continue with the third lie he made in this video.
لا ينهاكم الله عن الذين لم يقاتلوكم في الدين. God does not forbid you for those who did not fight you for your religion and took you out of your homes, that you treat him righteously and justifiably. Another one, ولا يجرمنكم شنآن قوم.
You see, this verse he is mentioning, we will show you that this verse has nothing to do with war. Actually, it's about for the benefit of Muslims, because in here, Muhammad, actually, you will hear my answer in a second.
God himself in the Quran, I'm sure you missed this one.
Trust me, I don't miss.
لا ينهاكم الله عن الذين لم يقاتلوكم في الدين. God does not forbid you for those who did not fight you for your religion and took you out of your homes, that you treat him righteously and justifiably. Another one, ولا يجرمنكم شنآن قوم على ألا تعدلوا اعدلوا هو أقرب للتقوى. Do not use the aggression and the oppression of people to use it as an excuse to treat him the same way. Treat him righteously and justly.
Do we still have Christian Prince? One final comment, Christian, because we have to move on.
Regardless of those who kick you out of your family, this was not about the war. Go and read the interpretation. This was about the mother of Aisha. When she came, she wanted to give a gift to Aisha. She went to Muhammad. She asked him, can I receive a gift from my mother, Muqahafa? He said, yes, accept from her gift. This was about accepting gifts, not about war. So you are lying again.
Let us prove what I said is true. That this is about gift, and he made it as about peace and war. Let us go and see it. This is Ibn Kathir, as you see in front of your eyes, and this is the interpretation. Simply, it was about the mother of Aisha. She want to give gift to her daughters. Here we go. Read with me. Do you see it? The daughter of Abu Bakr. This is a sister of Aisha, Asma, bint Abu Bakr. Her mother, she came to her with some gifts. So Aisha, she entered into the house. Asma, she refused to let her get inside the house with her gifts. This is Asma, the sister of Aisha. So Aisha, she went to Muhammad and asked him, can we receive the gifts from my mother? He said, yes. And this was during the time of the treaty. And this verse is even abrogated. This verse is even abrogated. It's not even exist to follow in the Quran. Read with me, please. Here we go. You see it in front of your eyes. Come to me during the treaty of peace. There is a treaty of peace in here. There is peace of it. And actually, chapter 9, verse number 1, it was Muhammad who broke the treaty. Chapter 9, verse number 5, Muhammad, he says, fight them until they convert, until they pray, until they follow Islam and repent. So what the problem, what the fight between those people was? It's about Islam. It's not about anything. Muhammad is the one who is attacking them. So because the mother of Aisha, she was going to kill her kids. She was an enemy of Muhammad. What she want to do? So imagine how they change the meaning of the verses and make it about war and peace, when the fact is about receiving cheese. Look, it's about some gifts such as dibab, cheese, and what this have to do with the? And let me show you that this verse is abrogated, just to expose him more, because the mentioned verses have nothing to do with reality in Islam. That the verse is about accepting cheese, and you Muslims make it about peace and war. Accepting from who? From the mother of Aisha. It's not even about something like a big deal. You make it about being good to others. What about killing them? What about taking their countries? What about taking them as slaves? And now you want to fool us that by accepting a gift of the mother of Aisha, you became good, and this about peace? What a liar you are. And this is how those hypocrites, they turn cheese into peace. Lord have mercy. Follow with me with more videos, guys, and let us laugh more at more lies Muslims they come with. And I hope that Muslims will see the truth, and the truth will set them free. Christ is Lord, and Islam is false. I mean to that.